Hello students, in present video I am going to explain about 8th problem from accounting for not-for-profit organizations. I am taking this question from Telangana State Telugu Academy inter-second year accountancy test book. But this video is useful to all commerce students who want to know about this topic. First 7 lectures videos links and this question are available in the description box. Let us see the question first. From the following receipts and payments account and other details of Laharika Charitable Trust, prepare income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2020. Receipt side, payment side. Debit side, 2 opening balance 20,450. 2 subscriptions 21,250. In brackets, including 750 rupees for 2018 and 19. 2 life membership fee 1300 rupees, 2 interest on investments 1000, 2 donations 10,000 rupees. Credit side, payment side, buy salaries 6,000 rupees, in brackets including 400 for 1819, buy telephone charges 800 rupees, buy printing 600, buy traveling 650, buy rent 5,400, buy books 3,000, buy charities 5,000. By balance carried down 32,550. Two sides total 54,000 rupees. Additional information. First point, subscriptions received in advance 1500 rupees. Second, outstanding rent 450 rupees. Third, the value of investments 40,000 and the rate of interest is 3%. Fourth one, donations are received for a prizes to be awarded by the trust. Let us solve this problem. In question, he has given receipts and payments account for the year ended 31st March 2020 and he is asking us to prepare income and expenditure account for the same date. So 31st March 2020 is the last date of their accounting period. If last date is 31st March 20, starting date is 1st April 2019. So current year is 2019 and 20. For current year, they are preparing final accounts. Their final accounts contains receipts and payments account, income and expenditure account and balance sheet. Now receipts and payments account is given in the question. We have to prepare income and expenditure account. Income and expenditure account is a nominal account. So nominal account rule we have to apply while preparing this account. Nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So as per that rule, organization related expenses and losses we have to show on debit side of this account and the incomes and gains we have to show on credit side. Let us see the receipts and payments account. In receipts and payments account, debit side he is giving receipts, credit side payments. Receipts are of two types. Capital receipts, revenue receipts. Both are appearing in receipts and payments account. But in income and expenditure account, only revenue receipts we have to take on credit side. Capital receipts means rare incomes. Revenue receipts means regular incomes. First one, opening balance 20,450. Opening balance means opening cash balance. Previous year closing cash balance becomes opening cash balance for current year. So opening cash balance we should not show in this account. Because cash is an asset, assets we should not show here. Ignore. Next, subscriptions 21,250. Subscriptions means our organization members to continue their membership, regularly they pay some amount to us. This is known as subscription. As it is a regular income, it is revenue income. We have to show on the credit side. And in brackets, he is giving that including 750 for 2018-19. So this is called adjustment. As adjustment is given, the main amount 21,250 we will take in inner column. By subscriptions 21,250 rupees. And in brackets he is giving that including 750 for 2018-19 year. Current year is 2019-20. So 18-19 means previous year. Previous year amount also included in this amount. But we want to know the surplus or deficit of current year. For that sake, we are preparing this account. If you want to know the current year surplus or deficit, only current year incomes, current year expenses we should take in this account. If previous amounts are included in this amount, or if next year amounts are included in this amount, we have to reduce them. Therefore, previous year subscription amount we have to deduct here. Minus previous year, 750 rupees. Remaining amount I am writing in inner column because one more adjustment is there. Adjustment number 1. Subscriptions received in advance 1500 rupees. Meaning is next year income, subscription income we received in current year only. Next year income also we have to reduce here. Minus received in advance 1500 rupees. Remaining amount in outer column. So current year subscription income is 19,000 rupees. Next, life membership fee 1300 rupees. Life membership fees means sometimes organization gives some offer to members. That is life membership. Means a member can be a permanent member for the organization. So regularly he has to pay subscription to continue his membership. If he pays life membership fees amount, then he need not to pay subscription amount every month. Thus, some members paid life membership fees to us. In the absence of any information, life membership fee is to be treated as capital income because huge amount comes. If any instruction is given in the question, we have to follow that. Let us see the instructions. Related with life membership fee, there is no instruction. Therefore, it is to be treated as capital income, means where it appears under liability side of balance sheet. Not here. So ignore. Next one, interest on investments. Firm invested their money in some securities. On them, regularly interest comes. So as this is regular income, it is a revenue income. It appears on credit side. And related with these investments, there is one adjustment. Third point, the value of investments 40,000 and the rate of interest is 3%. So we purchased 40,000 worth of securities. And every year on this 40,000 worth of securities, 3% interest should come. In rough notes, let us see how much interest should come on these securities. 40,000 rupees into 3% means 3 by 100. 1200 rupees. So in current year, 1200 interest should come. But in receipts and payments account, on debit side is giving that interest on investments 1000. So 1200 should come, but only 1000 rupees came. So 200 rupees subscription to be received. Directly he has to give subscription to be received 200. But here this adjustment is given in an indirect manner. So by seeing the amounts, we should only understand that there is some adjustment here. This is called hidden adjustment. Income and expenditure account is prepared under accrual basis. So in accrual basis, not only received incomes, income to be received also we should consider. Similarly, not only paid expenses, outstanding expenses also we should consider. Therefore, that a received interest 1000 rupees and outstanding interest, interest to be received 200 rupees. Both we have to show in income and expenditure account. Credit side, by interest on investments. First write down received amount 1000 rupees plus to be received. More 200 rupees should come. That 200 you have to add to this 1000. And how this 200 came, clearly show here. Investments value 40,000 rupees. On that 3% interest should come. Interest income is 1200 rupees. In this 1200, only 1000 amount we received. So more 200 we have to receive. Everything clearly show in the brackets. Now this 200 is appearing here. Add both and write down the amount in outer column. 1200 rupees. Next one, donations 10,000 rupees. Donation is one income. Somebody gave some gift to us because we are running one charitable trust. Our trust name is Laharika Charitable Trust. So we are engaged in social services. Therefore, somebody has given donation to us. Donation income is of two types. Specific donation, general donation. If that donation amount is received for a specific purpose, it is known as specific donation. Without mentioning the purpose of usage, if donor gives that amount, it is to be treated as general donation. In receipts and payments account, there is no information regarding that, whether it is a specific donation or general donation. But in adjustments, he has given clearly. Point number 4. Donations are received for a prizes to be awarded by the trust. So this donation money, they want to use for giving prizes to the candidates. So this is specific donation. Specific donations are to be treated as capital incomes. Because once if that purpose is survived, we don't receive the donation for that particular purpose again. So it is a rare income, means capital income. In balance sheet, under liability side, we have to show this amount, not in income and expenditure account. Receipt side completed, debit side completed. Now come to credit side. Credit side, he gives capital payments, revenue payments, both. Only revenue payments we should consider on debit side. While taking the amounts, even adjustment amounts also we should consider. First one, salaries. Salaries firm pays to employees on regular basis, every month. This is revenue expenditure. Therefore, we have to show that on debit side. Two salaries. Adjustment is given, therefore amount in inner column. Salaries amount 6,000 rupees. In brackets, he is giving that including 400 for 18-19. 2018-19 is previous year, no? So previous year salary expenditure is also included in the 6,000 rupees. Only current year incomes and expenses we should consider. If any previous year amounts are included, we have to reduce them. We have to subtract them. So minus previous year. Previous year salary amount is 400 rupees. Then current year salary expenditure 5,600 in outer column. Next one. Telephone charges 800 rupees. This is regular expenditure, revenue expenditure. We have to debit that. Two telephone charges 800 rupees. Printing 600 rupees. This is also regular expenditure. Regularly, this firm spends money on printing tickets, otherwise some invoice books, etc. It is a revenue expenditure, debit side of this account. To printing 600 rupees. Next, traveling expenses 650 rupees. This is also regular expenditure, debit side. Rent 5,400. Every month firm has to pay the rent. So revenue expenditure, debit. Rent. Adjustment is given. Therefore, write down the amount in inner column. Adjustment number 2. Outstanding rent 450. Means for current year, more 450 rupees we have to pay. So this is prepared on accrual basis now. Therefore, expenditure paid, expenditure to be paid. Nothing but outstanding expenditure. Both we should write. Plus outstanding 450 rupees. Total in outer column 5,850. Books 3,000 rupees. Payment said he gave books. Means they purchased books and they paid money. Books purchase is treated as capital payment because books come under fixed asset. Regularly they don't buy. Purchase of books, capital expenditure, but purchase of newspapers and magazines, revenue expenditure. Remember, books they purchased for 3,000 rupees, this is capital expenditure, we have to ignore. Related to that, there is no additional information also. Next, charity is 5,000 rupees. Observe the name, Laharika Charitable Trust Income and Expenditure Account we are preparing. as this is charitable trust, for them charity expenditure is common. Social service related expenditure is common. It is regular payment, means revenue payment. This is debit. So charities, 5,000 rupees. Last one, balance carried down 32,550. So in receipts and payments account, debit side he gave opening cash balance, credit side he gave closing cash balance. Closing cash balance appears as an asset in balance sheet of current year. So this is balance sheet item, we should not write here. So receipts and payments account, all amounts we have taken. Let us observe whether we have taken all adjustment amounts or not. First point, subscriptions received in advance, completed. Second one, outstanding rent over. Third, related to investment, interest adjustment also we have completed. Fourth one is donations are received for prize fund. That point also we have considered. Finally, we have to find out the surplus or deficit. For that, we have to observe which side total is more. Credit side total is more. In rough notes, credit total we have to calculate 20,200 minus debit total. Debit total is 18,500. Difference 1,700 rupees. We credited incomes, we debited expenses. Income is more than expenditure. Therefore, answer is surplus. Debit total is less. So, debit side, you have to show this amount, 1700 rupees. For this, you have to write surplus. Now, two sides put the totals. Credit total is more. So, two sides, you have to write that amount. Two sides total, 20,200 rupees. So, this is all about 8th problem from accounting for not-for-profit organizations topic. Hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.